Hi, Cancer. It's Sloane Rhodes here with your life purpose career reading for July, August, September 2016. I'm going to be drawing one card from the Fairy Tarot, looking at the general energies around your life purpose during this period. Three cards from the Life Purpose Oracle deck and one card from the Magical Fairies Oracle deck. And let me go ahead and draw the cards and we'll get started with your reading. Cancer, for life purpose and career for July, August, September 2016. Seven of Spring, support card flipped up. Come on, books, let me pick one. I think your guidance system is helping me along here, Cancer. My guidance system is connecting to yours. Artist, okay. So we have the support card, beautiful card. We have books. Right in the center, we have artist at the end. Then let me get one more from the Magical Fairies. And I'll start your reading, Cancer. Hang on 1 second. Your desire is within reach. Have faith, and as everything is working in your favor. Lovely card. All right, let me just take in these energies for you, Cancer, and then I'll start your reading. I feel like during this time period, Cancer, there's a strong desire to look back at the past. You may be feeling very reflective. You may be having some nostalgia about the past in terms of your life purpose. You may be looking to the past for clues about what you are meant to be doing. And I know many of you know this already, but you know your life purpose is not something that ever exists outside of yourself. It is revealed from within, with each and every moment, really. And with the thoughts that you think and the feelings that you experience and the actions that you take. And the more that you're able to do this consciously, the more that you can feel more empowered and take a position of direction, so to speak, about where you want your life to go, as opposed to being kind of whipped around by the energies of life, so to speak. But what I do see is, again, that sense of kind of looking back here, wanting to go backwards a little bit. That's okay, you know. A lot of times when we're doing a lot of forward movement, sometimes it can feel too much and we want to put the brakes on it a little bit, or we might want to look to the past so we can understand, you know, how, where we've grown, where we've changed, and how we want to go on. So, but what I do see here is with the Seven of Spring energy, it's really interesting because I feel like, in your, you know, you're very pulled by the moon, being a Cancer, water sign, the tides, the moon, and its effect on the tides. And I'm really being drawn to this lunar energy for you here, Cancer. And again, it feels like she's being pulled backwards a little bit, because she's feeling as if the future is a little frightening, is how it feels to me. And I say she, but it obviously could mean he or she. This is a female fairy. And make sure that you're seeing things clearly, Cancer, because a lot of times when we look to the past, we have those rose-colored glasses on, and we don't actually see things clearly as they really were. We have that sense of happy nostalgia, romanticizing the past. It kind of feels a little bit like that for me here. For some of you Cancers, but for others of you, it does indicate that, you know, the need to be assertive, to stand your ground, if you are looking to make changes, or if you're happy where you're at and you're getting pressure to do something different, and you feel internally that what you know is right, you know, trust your instincts very strongly, but just check in with yourself as well to make sure you're seeing the situation clearly. Whatever that might be for you, it's going to be different for everybody. And I see here two Cancer that, I'll show you how I see it. It's really, really interesting. We have the support card, we have the books card, and both of them looking towards the past. And then we have the artist card. And I kind of feel like in some ways, you don't feel that supported. You possibly think that in the past you felt more supported by your, by what you wanted to do. I get it. Okay. Yeah, so there's that, you've been working hard towards something and you're at the precipice of moving forward into something new, and you're like, nope, I'm going to bury my nose in the book, and that's actually kind of scary. I thought I wanted this thing and now it's coming for me, and it's I need to do more research, you know. And you kind of want to go inward a little bit. Even this fairy is like very, or angel is very down. And I feel like because we have this, your desire is within reach, a lot of times our ego comes in and makes us kind of doubt ourselves. Like we're working so hard towards something and then suddenly it's like, oh, it's almost attainable. And then we're like, no, I don't want it after all. I want things to stay the same. I want to go back to the way they were. But you know, that's never really possible because things never stay the same. They're always constantly changing. You're constantly evolving. But it does look like as you move forward, after you have this kind of period of possibly looking to the worst of the past, feeling a little defensive maybe, again, it's going to be different for everybody. For some of you, you will feel a very strong forward momentum, and you can kind of like smell success coming with that your desire is within reach. So however it kind of manifests for you, regardless, central to this reading is this book's card. And so for many of you, it will indicate that part of your life's purpose will involve books of some kind, studying of some kind. It'll always be kind of be who you are. You like to do research. You like to have things planned a little bit. It makes you it makes you feel a little safer, more secure. But regardless of that, moving forward during this time frame, we have this artist card, and it says, engaging in artistic activities is beneficial to your career and every area of your life, Cancer. And, you know, Cancer, again, the water sign, you know, it's very intuitive. A lot of Cancer people are very artistic and creative in many ways. And so you are just kind of a nod from your guides and angels, Cancer, that you, if you've forgotten this part of yourself, it's very obvious and present for you during this time period. You may even feel the need to pick up a paintbrush, to engage in writing, whatever you feel is creative for you. It's a strong urge during this time period, especially as we get towards the end of it. Again, even she is kind of looking towards the past. It's almost as if you're just not sure, really. Or you just don't feel that sense of confidence yet. And that's okay, because you know, you're whenever we are growing and changing, there's like, you know, we're going up kind of, sometimes it's kind of like a hill, and sometimes our footing slips a little bit, and we go down a little bit, but then we keep going. And it feels like during this period for you, Cancer, there will be this sense of looking back a little bit. I mean, I've said it a million times now, but it's just, I feel it so strongly. Let me get some additional cards on the Seven of Spring for you, Cancer. I know it's not exactly, I feel like this, the cards are being intentionally vague. The messages that are coming through are being intentionally vague as to exactly like what you're supposed to be doing with your life purpose. But there's a reason for that, Cancer, and it's going to be different for everybody. But I think right now, because it is kind of a period of reflection, looking towards the past a little bit, really kind of figuring out what you want to defend yourself about, what you want to be assertive about. Ace of Autumn, beautiful card, just pulled up. Whatever it is you're working towards, there's potential for tremendous material success and gain there. It also can indicate a happy change in your career, which is kind of what I was already saying. Like, I feel like you're on that kind of that precipice, the brink of doing something different, and it's kind of got you like a little freaked out, or not even freaked out. For some of you, it'll be a freak out, but for many of you, it'll just be that kind of sense of like nostalgia, looking back, wondering how the past affects you today and in your future. Okay, so we have the Ace of Autumn, which again I already spoke to, is that wonderful potential for material gain, success, change, a happy change in your career, possibly receiving a sudden windfall of money or advice or assistance from others. It's very, very, very nice card. Very nice energy for you. And then we have the Princess of Winter. And this could be information that comes in that isn't always easy to hear, but is really meant for your best and highest good. And then we have the Eight of Spring. Again, this is more messages, message energy coming in. It could be that you're getting messages. Also that you're just doing a lot of juggling. You're juggling a lot during this time period. Whatever is going on with that, be assertive, stand up for yourself. Look to the past if you need to, but just make sure you're seeing things clearly and you're not getting a little bit paranoid here. Just, you know, be courageous as you move forward, because there is a lot of potential here. And so whatever your instincts are kind of drawing you towards here, whatever this is about for you, Cancer, there's a lot of potential there, and I think you sense that. And some of the information that comes in may be difficult to hear. Again, this could be fast information coming in very, very quickly, and it could just mean that you're juggling a lot of different things during this time period. I think I want to get one more for you. But again, I'm really drawn to this beautiful Your Desire is Within Reach card. Have faith as everything is working in your favor. So there's a lot of things happening, it looks like, especially with that Eight of Spring energy right there. And all that self-reflection, all that looking backwards. Again, you might be feeling that sense that maybe your life purpose isn't supporting you anymore. You are moving in a new direction. But it looks like there is going to be that a little bit of a timeout as you kind of, not necessarily even a timeout, but kind of a more of a looking backwards with those rose-colored glasses a little bit. Yeah, the quiet. I go into peaceful silence and I listen. It's kind of what I was just saying, like that period of nostalgia going on here. These moments are important though, Cancer. I don't want to minimize them. You know, we're so goal-oriented in this society. We're always like, what's the next step? You know, what steps can I take to get to this other place? And then once you get to that place, you're like, oh no, now what do I need to do to keep progressing? And sometimes you just need to sit and be and reflect and look to the past a little bit. And if you are feeling like, oh, it was so good back then, you know, allow yourself a little bit of daydreaming like that. But you don't want to live there, you know. This is a time to allow yourself some of that reflection, but you are being asked to actively engage in your artistic pursuits, the ways that you like to be creative in the world. And your desire is within reach. Whatever that is for you, Cancer, keep going. You're doing beautiful. Just allow yourself that quietude. I love this card. It's so pretty. I go into peaceful silence and I listen. Listen to your intuition, Cancer. It will never fail you. All right, I hope you find that helpful. I wish you much love, and I hope to see you on the next video or at your private reading.